Coming out more when you're talking about the Adrien Brody kiss. Again, Halle Berry is a sexualized body.
Right.
And it's okay for him to do that because, again, she has been the submissive woman now. Mm-hmm. Right? So how can she now break out of that stereotype?
Mm-hmm. He can own her.
He can own her.
Even temporarily.
Yes. Sure, exactly. Yeah.
And it doesn't matter if they've ever met before.
Yeah. No social consequences.
It's an individual's choice to accept these images for themselves and for who they are. She's accepted the image of to play the Jezebel role, and now she can't break out of that even when she's not acting.
But the Adrien Brody kiss, it could have been that she's just this dream girl in Hollywood as well. Like Julia Roberts, I know someone in their speech once mentioned like they were dying to like either hug her or kiss her or something, like if they could, they would to Julia Roberts. And I was like, yeah, because she's like the pretty woman, that's her first film, and you know, people do think Julia Roberts is a dreamy American kind of sweetheart. Maybe Halle Berry could have been this dreamy girl, but I feel like she, I don't know, like, we just listed so many complications, like, with her character that I guess that is not even an option at this point. For her to just exist in this dreamy Hollywood, I want to have, if I could have, you know what I mean?
She can be that. I think she can exist, and she's a beautiful woman.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But you wonder, if it had been Julia Roberts, would he have given himself permission
to do that, right?
Her?
Good question.
You know, and people do a lot of crazy things at the award shows, and so, you know, it was not a
big to.
Yeah. But people sometimes do give themselves more permission with some people than with other people.
Sure.
With people who they perceive to, and they don't even have to do any whole lot of, you know, brain thinking. I mean, there's no calculation going on here.
Right.
It is so ingrained in us. Mm. You know what lines you can cross and which ones you can't.
Mm. Mm-hmm. You know, I started thinking about Halle Berry, and I'm thinking of the fact that there can only be one current, you know, black, beautiful actress at a time. Right, so I'm thinking about Halle Berry, and then it got me thinking about Dorothy Dandridge.
Mm-hmm.
Right, when Dorothy Dandridge was around, you know, how competitive that was with Lena Horne.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a moment in which Lena had to take the back road to Dorothy Dandridge, and then, of course, when she passed, or committed suicide, I think, then Lena Horne comes up, you know, and then after that, all these other... So I wonder, it's so different from white actresses, where there can be many actresses,
right,
all vying for these roles and all that.
Right.
But for black actresses, you know, there can only be one star at the moment.
And for Jennifer Lopez and Eva Longoria.
Yeah.
When Jennifer started messing with Mark Anthony, and she kind of took the back seat, and more and more, as Desperate Housewives got more popular, Eva Longoria gained the front seat as turned the Latina actress.
So it was really interesting to see this shit.
Can only be one woman of color.
Well,
Interesting.
But then again, that also goes to how the culture controls.
Mm-hmm.
And so,
mm-hmm.
you know, it is easier to control through film and television.
Yep. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And so the most problematic images are on film. And you would be so worried about people seeing you as a Jezebel that you don't get to claim your sexuality.
Mm-hmm. I agree with the control being in me, but I have to say, even from my like England experience, like being abroad, I did, when I went to the nightclubs, feel like this black golden chocolate idol that these white European men were like, oh, she's so beautiful because of the way she dances and because she's black.
It's not so much that it challenges my sexuality, because I'm very free and open and happy to express it, but it's not something that's controlled by anyone but me.
Pink Lemonade is about family and broken heart. It gives black women more value than just in their bodies or with just sex, you know. It's definitely more than that. It's definitely saying black women are more than just sex, are more than just a piece of meat. And then the fight, that's probably a piece where like Corinthia conveys that she's not gonna have a guy cheating on her, or she's not that type of woman. She'd rather be respected, taken to nicer places, on dates, and there's some value and some worth to her. And she put that on herself, and I don't think the Jezebel did that, so.
But you gonna miss me one day, real soon.
I know I miss you, Kevin. I don't worry so much more than you.
I think it's about who has, or who's actually given control for
for a moment. I mean, I think of someone like Julie Dash.
Right.
Illusions, Daughters of the Dust. I mean, you know, amazing, amazing film. But has she ever won an Academy? Has she ever had done a full-length feature film that has gone, you know, nationwide? Mm-hmm. Not really. You think about someone like Cheryl Dunye. You think about, you know, all these amazing filmmakers, but they have not been given the opportunity.
And I felt like in order for these, for the diversity in a Black woman's experience to be, I guess, like, shown in media, we need to kind of create a place where that can be. So outside of, I'm all about not using the masses tool. So outside of the Tyler Perry, Madea figure, there needs to be a place where Black women and whatever Black men as well can represent the Black experience to all its diversity and all its awe and whatever it attains, you know? So I just think that needs to be created. And within that, we can move forward. And I would like the Black community to support these things, because those are the things that represent who we
and
are.
And even for me as a Black woman to create and direct this on my own, like, I think, I mean, I know people know that Black women are capable of doing their own work and maybe producing their own work, but where it's like at Dickinson, people know Tanisha Wright, you know? And that feels really good.